Guys, whatever you can believe, na, you can do. Whatever it is. It only looks impossible till the time you actually try doing it. All my life's major achievements have come after the age of 32, 31. It's about going beyond your limit, because that's the only way you can beat yourself on a daily basis. You have to be better than what you were yesterday. Yes, that's right, ladies and gentlemen. Today is the first day for the rest of your lives. I was 31, 32, sitting in a jail. Yes, exactly. I was in jail. The jail. And thinking, okay, now this is my life, because this is not the first time I've been here. And that seems to be a very regular basis of this happening. I was trying to live up to this branding. Branding of being a gunda, being a gangster. Did I brand myself as that? No. It was the media, the public, my friends who wanted me to live up to that image. In fact, wanted me to improve on that every day. And I was falling for that. And I was falling for that in a bad way, because I thought my only competition is 5 billion people living in this world, or 1 billion people living in India, or maybe just probably, if I say my work, line of work, 100,000 or 1 million, whatever your odds are. One day, while sitting in jail, I asked that person, which person? The only person who I cannot lie to. Guys, the only person you cannot lie to is who? Yourself. I asked myself this question, looking at a mirror. Are you happy? Are you happy with this branding? Is this the branding you want for the rest of your life? Are you happy with your life? Yes, you are earning crores. But to earn those crores, what are you doing? You're making other people miserable. And not only that, you're also onto drugs. Why? Because to compete with them, you need to be performing for 24 hours a day. And that was the reasons which brought me there. And if I had to be in that line, probably wouldn't have been alive today. So, one day, I slapped myself and I said, today is the first day for the rest of my life. Yes, that's right, ladies and gentlemen. Today is the first day for the rest of your lives. You are all born today. It's never too late for anything. So, what I thought was, how do I first get rid of this branding? Not in people's mind, in my own mind. I have to prove to myself I am not what they say I am. So I have to make sure I do things which are out of my comfort zone. So I had a problem with heights. I went for skydiving. I have 40 jumps to my name now. I was scared of the water. I was really scared of water. I'm a master scuba diver, PADI certified. That means I can teach people scuba diving. Then, I thought, what's the most difficult thing known to mankind? They said, climbing Mount Everest. Why? Because mountaineering is supposed to be the world's most dangerous sport. Why? Because for K2, the second highest mountain, for every two people who summit, one dies. Mount Everest, for every four, one dies. And the only place actually in life where you can have competition truly with yourself on a daily basis is a mountain. Because your only competition is the mountain, and actually it's just you. How far you can push it. But it's very dangerous. See, I did Mount Everest, 8,848 meters. I did a 2,000 meter mountain, then 3,000, then 4,000, then 5,000, then 6,000. Then 7,200, I went to this mountain called Mount Pumori. It is right next to Mount Everest. And Nepalese Mount Pumori means daughter of Mount Everest. Everest Base Camp, which is at 5,500 meters, is already higher than the summit of every other mountain in every other continent. That means the only mountains you can find higher than from where you start climbing Everest is in Asia. Otherwise, everywhere in the world, even the summit is lower than Everest Base Camp, 5,500 meters. What happens? Why do you die? Why are there so many chances of conking out? Hap, hack. High altitude pulmonary edema or cerebral edema. Because of the pressure, your own liquids fill up in your lungs or in your brain and you drown inside your body with your own liquids. Frostbite. You take your gloves off, the temperature is so cold, your hands start swelling up, become black and blue. You can actually literally break your arm off if it's that frozen. Hypothermia, because the temperature is between minus 30 to minus 45 degrees. Lot of times you die just because of excessive cold. Hypoxia, 1/3 oxygen available than there is at sea level. You can die of a small stone this much. What do you mean? My climbing partner is climbing on top of me and by mistake, his crampon moves a little stone. That stone falls 200 meters and hits you right here. You die. No control. A crevasse opens up and you fall inside. And the nearest medical help from Everest Base Camp is 4 days walk. Helicopter rescue not possible above Camp 1 because the rotors can't catch on. And when you're climbing even any high mountain above 8,000 meters or 7,500 meters, which has been done by humans, you will find bodies of humans there. For example, when you climb Everest in the death zone, there's a Japanese woman sitting like this, but she sat there 20 years ago. And you are reminded of death every single second there. By the way, 2 years ago, if you remember, there was a huge earthquake in Nepal and over 100 people were killed at Everest Base Camp. Base Camp, where you start. And by the way, when you climb this mountain, you don't climb it once, you have to climb it 4 times. You go from Base Camp to Camp 1, spend the night at Camp 1, come back to Base Camp. Base Camp to Camp 2, spend the night there, come back to Base Camp. Camp 3, back to Base Camp. Camp 4, back to Base Camp. Did all that. Came back down, another challenge was waiting, which I took on myself. There's a glacial lake at the bottom of Mount Everest, and it's frozen 24 hours, obviously because the temperature is such. Except at 12 o'clock. Why? Because the sun is right on top. And the sun is so harsh, that's why I wear these things, skins, I've got used to them. If the sun hits my arm directly, it gives me third degree burns. That's how strong the sun is. So even if the temperature is in minus, the first 6 feet of that glacial lake are icy water. But no one has swum that. Obviously, no one has swum that because if anything goes wrong inside that lake, no one will come to save you. Obviously. But one guy, one white guy, he came and did it there and broke a record. Became a new Guinness record for the highest altitude swim ever by a human being. But that guy's name is Tim Pugh. That's his job. He's gone and broken that record in 7 different places after that as the highest altitude swimmer and the coldest water swimmer. He's got programs on Nat Geo and Ice and Discovery now. And who am I? I am a person who has never liked water and who is not an expert swimmer. In fact, I hate cold water. I'm that kind of a person in this summer, which is 40 degrees. I hate having a bath with cold water, even now. But there, because someone told me that white guys have a better acclimatization and ability to withstand cold temperatures. That got me thinking that that's not true. If he can do it, I can do it. And that's all it takes, ladies and gentlemen, just belief in yourself. Guys, whatever you can believe, na, you can do. Whatever it is. It only looks impossible till the time you actually try doing it. If you dream it, you can do it. If you can't dream it, you can't even do it. That's the first step. Believing in yourself. Didn't do it for 9, did it for 11 seconds. It became a new India Book of Records, Limca Book of Records, and even Asia Book of Records. Now, understand, guys, this was possible because of a trick which I learned just before going for this expedition. I wish I had learned this trick 30 years ago. All my life's major achievements have come after the age of 32, 31. The ones I am proud of. Mind over matter. Doesn't matter what your limit is. Even if your limit is 0, you should be able to go to 0.5. Doesn't matter what your limit is, even if it's 20, you should be able to go to 25. It's about going beyond your limit because that's the only way you can beat yourself on a daily basis. You have to be better than what you were yesterday. So, suppose you have pain in your foot today and you have a painkiller. Does that mean the pain is gone? No. Just the signals which were coming from my foot to my brain have gone. The moment the painkiller wears off, the pain will start again. But if an outside chemical has been able to control the brain cells in my body which gives pain, I should be able to do that with my brain. So, everybody knows what squats are. Squats are, suppose there's a chair here and I'm sitting on a chair, but it's not a chair. I sit like this. So what will happen? You know what lactic acid is? You people go to the gym. So you go to the gym, you don't put exercises of 100 every day. Matlab sets 100 ke nahi lagate ho. Aap 12 ka lagate ho, 15, 18, 20, depending on the weight. Then you wait for 30 to 45 seconds and you put it again. You don't come the next day to do it. Why? Because you're able to recover. It's actually not you recovering, it's your body giving you the false thing that you have recovered. You can actually do all of them at the same time, at least 30, or at least 40, or at least 50, or at least 2 sets at 1. It's your brain limiting you. Now, lot of pain is coming and happening here. I am not used to this. It's really paining. Signals are coming to my brain and asking my body, what the hell are you doing? This is not potty, it's something else. So I try to tell them, I'm trying to give everybody a demo. Or how to control my body with my brain. Say, okay, hurry up, man. It's really paining a lot. Really paining. Shut up. I'm your master. You're my slave.
Stop talking this shit, master. Really, both paining. I'm really good guy.
Shut up. I'm your master. I can't feel anything. You're my slave. I can do this for 2 hours. And so can all of you. If I make you sit like this right now, and I put a chaku here, a big 12-inch knife here. I know you will not sit.
Hopefully.
See, end of the day is here. And it's about beating yourself on a daily basis. There is no branding which can ever be done by anyone on you. You will do your own branding to you. Whatever you believe in yourself, you can do. There will be no day known as it's being too late. That means it's never too late. Today is the first day for the rest of your life. Your life starts today. You can achieve anything you want. And your only competition is who? You. Even if you want to be a world champion, your competition is you. Be better than what you were yesterday, even if it's by this much. And one day, you will beat the world champion. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Bajaj.
Tell us what you think about this video and don't forget to like, share and subscribe.